circumstances, the judgment of reshuffling the entire cabinet seems to be a bit of a timeline. The fact that Prime Minister Narendra Modi has been on a back foot during the entire second COVID wave and has suddenly come into action that to be of this sort makes the general public a bit hazy about his intentions that are probably not in the favour of the welfare of the common public. He has managed to remove all those ministers who brought negative controversies to the Modi government in any manner in the past few years in order to keep the Modi brand in highlight positively. If we look closely at the working of the Modi government to speak of BJP, the only ones from the past that have been left in the government are Rajnath Singh and Nitin Gadkari. Now that the Modi government has decided and finally appointed the new cabinet ministers and those of the states, the general public must be aware of the unknowns. Council of Ministers has about 78 ministers, out of which approximately 42% have serious criminal cases against them related to murder, robberies and many more. These judgments and reshuffling of the cabinet leave a big question mark on the Modi government and its decision-making power capabilities forever. We do not know of the real objectives of PM Narendra Modi, but even if he aims to do any good for the Indian people, it is just not happening. Instead, all these actions and decisions prove to be a reckoning and add to the hardship of the common public.